Standard electrical outlets, as you use them, can wear and maybe not hold the plug as well as it used to. And sometimes you just need to change them out because they're broken or they're just worn or whatever. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do that safely and correctly and give you a few pointers along the way. Before we get too far into this, let me explain a couple things about the way houses are wired. Now, we're going to get too deep into this, but I just want you to understand a few things. Newer houses, say in the last 10 or 20 years, if you look behind the outlet, are going to have a box, and in most cases it's going to be a plastic box like this. And this is designed for use with this type of wire, which is called Romex. It's plastic sheathed, and that's pretty typical for newer style houses. If you have a little bit older house, you may have a metal box behind the outlet, and that could have either the Romex that I'm talking about, or it may have cable like this coming into it, which is armored cable. And there's a few different varieties of it, and that was just designed for greater protection. Also, if you have a barn or a garage, you may also see this Romex cable, and that always terminates in a metal box. There are different methods to check for electricity being on or off. You could use a meter or even plug in a lamp or something like that to the outlet, but this little device here, of which there's a few different varieties, checks for electricity in the cable and in the outlet itself. And you can pick it up at your big box store fairly inexpensively. I press a switch on, and it beeps if there's electricity. Same thing with the outlet here. Your breaker box, or if you have a really old house, it could be a fuse box. But a breaker box looks something like this. And you have the main breaker up top, and then you have the sub-breakers, which control various different circuits. So at the very least, you want to make sure that the circuit you're working on is off. And you would do that just by flipping the breaker off, or if you just can't find it or it's too complicated, you can always turn off the main and that would turn everything off. All right, I'm going to do the rest of this demonstration here on the workbench just because it's easier to show on the camera. Now, in your box, you're going to have wire coming in, at least one cable, and you may have many cables coming into this and going back out. There is rules about how much wire can be in a box. So if it's a relatively new house, presumably it was inspected when it was installed and you don't have any problems. If it's an older house and you see a whole bunch of wire stuffed in there and it looks like quite a bit of mess, it's probably a good idea to call an electrician and not try to do this yourself. But let me just show you the parts of an outlet so we understand what we're dealing with here. This is the side you're familiar with seeing. And on the side, you're going to see terminals. There's two brass terminals here, and on the opposite side, there's two silver terminals, okay? There's also, let me just get a screwdriver here to show you, a little bridge that connects these two terminals. It's right here. So there's these two terminals and there's a little bridge right here. That bridge is normally connected, and that would mean that both of these outlets are on the same circuit. In certain circumstances, this bridge you can break off with a pair of pliers, and that will separate this outlet from this outlet. And the reason you would want to do that is if you have a switched outlet. So occasionally you'll see in a bedroom where the bottom outlet is always on as part of the circuit, but the top outlet, for example, is on a switch. And in order to do that, you break off this tab here and you break off the tab on the other side, and that separates these two. But for most circuits in a house, this is always going to be connected, so you probably won't have to worry about that. Now, in addition to those two terminals, you'll often see on the back of newer outlets these little holes right here, which are designed, or actually right here, which are designed to push a wire in, and that is supposed to hold it. I never want to see you use these things. They're an awful idea. They're used for basically a cheap way out. If an electrician is doing a lot of work, he can jam the wires in there and call it a day, and it just takes less time and effort to get it done. But those wires tend to loosen up over time, and I've seen an awful lot of scorched outlets from remodeling work that I've done. So I just don't recommend using these, and just ignore that they're there. All right. So what we want to use are these terminals here. And you have the two sides I talked about, the brass and the silver. Okay. The brass or gold always goes to the black wire, all right? So gold and black. The silver side always goes with the white wire. So you have white and silver. And that's really the only color coding you have to worry about. There's another terminal here which is green, and that's always the ground. and the ground is going to be the bare copper wire that you see here. Now, removing the outlet is pretty simple. Obviously, you take the cover off, and then there's going to be screws that you can see here in this new outlet, right here and right here, which screw into the box at the top and the bottom. So you're just going to unscrew those screws. Again, we've already made sure power is off, and you're going to pull the outlet out of the box as far as you can. Now, if you have a newer house, you probably will see this, like I say, where the wires are just shoved into the back here into these holes. To remove the wires from that, there's two things you can do. There are little slots here that you can stick a screwdriver in, but since we're just getting rid of this outlet, sometimes it's just easier just to take a pair of wire cutters and cut it off as close as you can to the outlet, and that will remove it, okay? Now, to make this realistic, let me talk about how circuits are put together typically. You have these four terminals here, right? Well, if this outlet was at the end of a circuit, in other words, it's the last outlet in a whole line of outlets, then you're just going to see one wire on one side and one wire on the other, right? You're going to have a black and gold and a silver and white, and that's all you're going to see. But if this outlet is in the middle of a circuit, in other words, there's outlets on the other side of it and before it, then what's going to happen is you have a black and a white feeding the two bottom terminals, say, and then a second set of wires which are feeding the next outlet. And that's how this works. It runs in a series or a loop. A wire stripper like this, I think, is the easiest way to strip the ends off the wire, or the insulation off the wire. And it is coated here. I mean, you don't really need to see that, but wire comes in different sizes. And typically in a residential situation, it's either 12 gauge or 14 gauge wire. What you want to do is, it'll be pretty obvious. You can start with a 12 if you're unsure. In this case, I know it's 14 gauge. So I just go to the right slot, and I'm taking off maybe about 3/4 or 7/8 of an inch and just stripping that off. So now the next question is, how do we connect these? It is important, neatness matters basically in electrical work. So when you wrap the wire around the base of this screw, you want to make a nice neat loop, and the way the screw turns, you want it to tighten against that wire and not spread it apart as you tighten the screw. Let me show you what I mean by that. If I take this wire here, in this case we're going to use our black wire, which goes to the gold terminal, right? I'm going to take this and make a loop, and I'm just taking my pliers here and just turning it like that. It's a little hard to do this with the camera in my way, but... And then I'm going to wrap it around the screw base. But you see the direction. In this case, the screw will be turning clockwise to tighten, and that's the way I want the loop to go as well. That way, when I tighten the screw, it'll tighten everything together. So I get that nice and tight in there. I'll take my screwdriver and tighten that down good and tight. How tight? Well, I mean, I give it a pretty good crank. Now, if these terminals are not used, then you're still going to want to take the screw and turn it all the way in so that it's not coming out and hitting the sides of the box when you install this, okay? Okay, I've made all my connections, and I want to show you something. Again, neatness matters. So if you see my wires coming in here, the bare copper is under that screw. The insulation, I don't know if you can see that in the camera, but comes up to the screw but not under the screw. That's important. And also important is you don't want bare copper coming way out, you know, behind the outlet, because that could expose the wire to being touched by another wire, and that could lead to a short. There's a couple different ways you may see a ground connected. You may see a wire tie like this, or wire nut, I should say, like this. And you may have the copper twisted together, the wire nut holding the end of it, and then another wire coming out, which is intended to go here on the green terminal. Or, if it's newer, and actually, if you can get away with this, it's just a lot easier. They make this special wire nut, which has a hole in the top. Okay, so to use this newer style ground nut, I've taken my Lyman pliers, hopefully you can see that, and twisted the copper wires together down here, leaving this one piece extended past. Now I take my special ground nut here, wire nut. The wire goes through the top up here, and then the nut just holds together the section down below. Okay, so let's double check what we've done here. We have, in this case, or this example, this outlet is in the middle of a circuit. So we have a black and gold from the one cable leading into the bottom, and a silver white leading in the top, and then from the other cable we have a black and gold and a silver and white here. We've taken our ground and we've put it to the green terminal down here. Our wires are not going to be too cramped in here. There's not too much wire in the box itself. Again, this is not sitting in a wall. Obviously, it's a little bit easier in that sense if it is. But now the last thing you might want to do is to wrap this whole outlet where the terminals are with electrical tape. I'm just going to take this black electrical tape, and this is kind of hard with the camera in my way here, but I'm just going to take one loop. I hold it with my thumb up here and wrap around, avoiding the screws, wrap around one side, avoid the screw again, and that's enough. And now the last thing we want to do is just shove this back in here, and because it's not mounted in the wall, it's a little more difficult, but you want to make sure that the wires are neatly dressed in the back and none of the ground, for example, is not touching any of the gold terminals, or any of the terminals for that matter. And we'll just push this back in until we get these screws on the top and the bottom engaging in the box where they should. All right, so that'll be there. This one will be in the bottom. And then it's just a matter of tightening those screws and making sure that there's a nice solid connection there. Now I want to show you one more thing in case you run into it. Sometimes in a kitchen or a bathroom, often I see it in a kitchen, where you'll be doing a tile backsplash. And this box was set in the wall in the same or flush with the wall board originally. But now you've put in a tile backsplash, and I don't know if I can do this on camera, but you'll see that the tile backsplash now is making the box sit, you know, below the surface of the wall. And sometimes the box just does that anyway from old age, or it wasn't installed correctly to begin with. But in this case, what happens is this outlet is going to be either too deep or it's going to sit on the new surface of the wall. And if the tile is there, for example, you would see what would happen is this outlet would come down and sit against the tile, and that would leave these terminals slightly exposed, and then they would be outside of the box. Okay, well, that's no good. So there is a solution for this. They look something like this. Now, you'd have to put this in before you connect the wires. Actually, you might be able to slip it around, but these are called box extenders. Basically, this sits just outside of the box and helps extend the box. Obviously, this can move back and forth as needed, so that these terminals are not exposed. Okay, let's assume we've put our outlet in, we put the cover on, and we think we're good to go. Put the breaker back on, and we want to test it. Little testers like this are very useful. They're inexpensive. You can buy them at the Home Depot or Lowe's or whatever. And they will tell you if you've wired this correctly or not correctly. All you got to do is plug it in. And I don't know if you can see this, but yeah, you can see that's lit up. And I have the two lights on the side there. That means, according to this code right here, that it's wired correctly. So these are invaluable, I think, just to making sure you do it right. In this case, we did. And it can also help test if the power's on as well. So this is a handy little device. I think it's, I don't know, $2 or $3 at a box store, and I highly recommend you pick one of those up. So that's how you replace your outlet, and if you're careful, safe, and neat about it, I think you'll be able to do it yourself.